we could probably explore to further build on the model. Because any model, I mean, I keep always pointing out whether it's this issue about endogeneity and what have you. You will always, there, any model, as mentioned by George Box, is wrong. All models are wrong, but some are useful. And so, in a way, models are like glasses that will help us see a reality, and that reality somehow changes, eh? Because our eyes also change. Sometimes you need better glasses, sometimes, you know. So that's what a model will do. So you can right now, this is what we're saying from that model, but can we improve the model? Maybe. I mean, let's try, you know. All we can do is try. Now, I'm certainly glad that Gilbert pointed that out, that, you know, really the issue about skills, because I've often wondered whether we have a very anti-intellectual culture in this country. Okay, let me give you one example. When you have people, I just keep pointing out, who win awards, sports, but when I remember when Dr. Concepcion, Mercedes Concepcion, noted demographer, won a UN Population Award, there was nothing in the news. Why? Because she was not a beauty queen. She was a population award, you know? You know, I mean, you see my point, that we're still far away from rewarding people for gaining the right knowledge, skills. I certainly hope that the K-12 will address it, but I have also some concerns, because I mean, one of the writers, by the way, of the statistics part, but the probability and statistics part, I did this for love of country also, no? But I also wonder whether, do you expect people who get into sports to do research? Because research is part of, I wonder, again, maybe we're adopting also certain, putting people into boxes, when innovation is getting out of a box.
Yeah.
In fairness to what Linda I remember I had to endure, I remember in high school, our professor in Florante at Laura made us memorize a whole page of pag-ibig ang ating nakilala, di dapat palakihin ang bata sa saya. At sa katuwa ay walang umihasa, kung lumaki, walang hihinting ginhawa. And you know, I will tell you, all of us, in my class, and all the classes of Mr. Vivencio Espino, when we all gather, that's the very first thing we will say to each other in meetings. No? That whole stanza in that whole page that we were all asked to memorize. And I look at my batch at La Salle Green Hills, you know, we didn't do too badly. You have Ogie Alcacid, you know, you have some people fairly well known. You know, Ogie is probably the most well known of all of us. But we also have a few other people who are into technology. Some of them did not come from the honor sections. But they did well. They have their own startups. So there are a lot of success stories. Eh? So it's really not just, you're right that you know, finishing a PhD will not be a guarantee for you to be an innovator. But it helps to build those kinds of skills. And I'm not too sure whether right now we have those programs for building the exact knowledge skills, and also the people skills and the management skills that people need, because I think, unfortunately, we don't have all these management seminars. I don't think DTI is addressing them. I'm not sure anybody from DTI, I cannot speak for them, but anybody from DTI, do you have those programs to help managers becoming innovators? You do. Okay, good for you. But then how much...
But we can only do so much,
yes,
of course.
See? It's only the, but how much of this I mean, kasi right, like right now, you have all of this Coursera, all the things that, all the MOOCs, massive open online courses, rather than giving them seminars, can you just send them a PowerPoint? Because some of them are too busy, they cannot even go because of all the traffic. You know, how can they attend? We are, by the way, we invited private sector people. I made sure, diba? I gave many, but how many people from private sector came? Very few, diba? We are invited from NBC, from so many, but maybe because it's, this is Quezon City and they're Makati and you know, all of these things, but that's why now we're, is this on? Oh my gosh, I should have done the same certain things. No, but anyways, little did I know. No, but anyways, my point here is that this is supposed to be a way for which, you know, we are reaching out to the people out there who cannot come here. But I would hope that DTI and others are also going to build on this, because even in the World Bank's report that we were mentioning about the innovation paradox, unfortunately, managerial skills, leadership is a really, it's a critical issue. So even if you have the right money, because if you think about it, you keep telling associations that this is what's needed, but will they act? Will the managers act? Sometimes they don't, because maybe they don't really know. They attend the meetings, but they're all hi to network, but maybe at the end of the day when they go back to their offices, I doubt if they really innovate organizationally. How many of us are doing all of these organic management practices, knowledge management practices? So we're still far, because it's easier for us to sing and dance. Isn't it? I mean, we're more of an entertainment culture rather than a scientific culture. We tend to look down on science and the arts, even anything creative. We glorify sports, we glorify entertainment a little bit, you know, all the, just because some movie star says this, automatically headlines. No? Some movie star dies in Qatar. I mean, I feel bad for her, but she's on the news. But how many of our OFWs who might have died in under similar circumstances getting into the news?